Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Up next, we'll see a man who's been in charge for more than a decade, Matthew Stafford and the Detroit Lions, as they square off against the number one pick, Kyler Murray, and the Arizona Cardinals. With that, let's get out to the desert. Standing by in Glendale, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside State Farm Stadium in Glendale. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up the heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with the Detroit Lions. With you from the booth, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. A CDR matchup here. A couple of teams last year that were really pretty similar. Both under 500, both missed the playoffs, and they both think that they can turn things around in 2019.
Yeah, how about 2018, though? A case of the haves and the have-nots. In 16-game seasons in the NFL, for the first time last year, no one finished 8-8. Now, you know that in baseball, basketball, other sports, turnarounds can take 3, 4, 5 years. In football, could just be a few months.
Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So out come the Cardinals now for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by the man running the show, Charles, their quarterback.
I read something prepping for this game that he said prior to, and I think he really said it a few months ago, where he talked about he wants to have the type of season that at the end, he's buying gifts for all the guys who have helped him along the way. And I know that the team wants to hold him to that and really get into his wallet. But that's what good leadership gives you. You know, at the end of the season, because you've done a great job, QB, he's usually the guy who springs for the good stuff.
So first and 10 now from the 30. This is David Johnson, the former All-Pro. They find some open field here. David Johnson on his way. Touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson, 70 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead.
Well, they said they wanted to have some explosive runs. How about that one to start the game?
And I would say on the defensive sideline, there's a lot to answer for. Because you spend all week saying, stop the run. I don't care who you're playing. You don't want to get run over. You don't want to get run past. And they got both overcommitting in the secondary. And he just went stepping past them and is still running, essentially.
One play and he hits pay dirt. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And the Cardinals will go up 7-0. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Lions offense and Matthew Stafford ready to go here. Stafford still a solid quarterback in his 11th season now, but the Lions still yet to win a playoff game under his guidance. And last year's mark of 6-10, the worst since 2012 for the Lions. Stafford and the Lions now have it 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Throw left side, taken in by Galladay. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line.
Now that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. A look at Kerryon Johnson, second-year man out of Auburn. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult third and 8 coming up. And now the offense for Detroit.
Running back Kerryon Johnson was drafted out of Auburn in the second round of 2018. To become the Detroit Lions' lead running back, something they haven't had in a long time. In fact, in 2018, he ran for over 100 yards in a game in September, the first Lions back over 100 yards since Reggie Bush on Thanksgiving Day in 2013. They're hoping that continues, and he'll be the three-down runner that they've been seeking.
Now Stafford, screen play, Johnson, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That winds up being a 4-yard loss and leads to fourth down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. Back deep, the dangerous Pharaoh Cooper. That'll be a 48-yard punt, 1 yard on the return. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Fake handoff to Johnson. Now here's Murray. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. And here are the offensive starters for Arizona.
We're all looking forward to watching David Johnson bounce back from a rough season in 2018 because we know he has 2,000-yard potential, 1,000 on the ground, 1,000 in the air. And with a new offensive-minded coach in Arizona, look for his numbers to truly increase in 2019.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Murray again, second and 10. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. And now the Lions' defensive starters.
As the Detroit Lions continue to rebuild their defense, they were so excited about the opportunity to acquire defensive end Trey Flowers from New England, who always put on big performances in the playoffs and in Super Bowls. And now the Lions looking forward to seeing that game in and game out. 7.5 sacks is his career high. They'd love to see that number get to double digits.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Throwing is Murray on third down. That's complete to Edmonds, his running back. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That'll go as a 16-yard gain as they pick up the first. Just the first quarter of a tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a long night.
Pushing forward for three up to the 48.
when we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. From the gun, a run for Johnson. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
To throw on third down, Murray. Eluded, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. They couldn't contain Deshaun Hand that time as he gets home for the sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. And Detroit getting set to go now. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Stafford now to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. And here is the Cardinal defense.
Safety DJ Swearinger brings not just athletic ability to the field, he also brings a strong belief that he can get to the football on every snap. An absolutely fierce hitter, you can feel his intensity even when you're sitting down and having a meeting with him prior to the game.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing again, Stafford completing it here to Marvin Jones. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 22 yards there, a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Theo Riddick. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. Faking the give to Johnson, now it's Stafford. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Here's Stafford. And he'll find Galladay. That's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The Lions passing game in sync now. They've got another first down.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that from him soon.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
Big series right here. You got to step it up.
Stafford going to give this one off to Johnson. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Stafford with a give. This is Riddick. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1 yard loss, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on 3rd down, Stafford. Over the middle, complete. That's James. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on 3rd down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the 1st down.
Into the red zone for the first time. They have a 1st and 10 at the 18. Stafford to Riddick on the draw. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Riddick with a carry, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a yard, and just like that, it's 3rd down. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Back to throw, Stafford. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. He couldn't hook up with Amendola there.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
After the turnover, here's Murray. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
all that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
And the head coach reaches for the red flag, tosses it down on the field. He wants a challenge here. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup. I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Third and two, and here's Murray. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Kyler Murray, a 1,000-yard rusher as a quarterback in his Heisman campaign at Oklahoma. He's got the first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
First down. Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 10 more there and another first down. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
A loss of two there, second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Murray now. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Trey Flowers, the former Arkansas Razorback, in there to get him. And, partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They covered everything, nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. On third down, Johnson. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field.
Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. Maybe anticipating a blitz and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up and they jumped.
A full start backs him up five, first and 15. Play action, Stafford. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, here's Stafford. And he finds Danny Amendola. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A good pickup, but it will come on what should be the final play in this first half. So we've reached halftime with just the lone touchdown here. 7-0 is our score. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been a hard-fought battle to this point. 7-0 is the score, but neither offense really able to get on track. But let's not waste any time. We'll get you right back out to Brandon and Charles for the second half.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And a great return, solid field position. He's up all the way to the 45-yard line.
That strong return has set them up nicely for this drive, and we all know the next score is going to have a major impact on this game.
The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. But it'll be second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again. Stafford, he's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. He finds Riddick complete.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Here's Sam Martin now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. On play action, it's Murray. Left side here, caught by Clay. And that play goes nowhere. He's met behind the line, and a penalty flag may add insult to injury. So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold.
Single.
Second down, Murray sets to throw. It's complete to his tight end, Charles Clay. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. Murray going to try to throw on third down, and that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Here's Andy Lee now, as he's on to punt for Arizona. And Detroit getting set to go now. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 18. On the ground, it's Riddick. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. And an alley to run. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success, how about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
On 1st and 10, Stafford. James has got it, complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Stafford now, 5 straight completions here in this second half. 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. A shotgun snap for Stafford. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. 10 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Certainly there are good things about quick strike offenses that score fast, but a long drive can also work to your advantage as well.
In so many ways, Brandon, because number one, you get them tired, but the big one is mentally. They can't figure out how to slow you down, how to get off the field, how to get the ball back. They go to the bench wondering, what are we going to do next time in order to stop those guys?
Prater for the extra point, and we are tied at 7. That time, a 6-play drive, and the end result, a Detroit touchdown. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Throwing on first down is Murray. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Murray. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Running from the gun, Johnson. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
I'm trying to collect. Check three.
Now Murray throwing on second down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Fitzgerald. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. This quarterback now, five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. On first and 10, here's Murray. Over the middle and caught by the tight end, Clay. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. On second down, here's Murray. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. To throw is Murray. Screenplay, Johnson. So they decline it as that will bring up fourth.
And I know that yardage and field position are keys to any game played, but you've got to consider downs when you're talking about penalties, and they wisely did not take that one and made it fourth down.
A big one coming now for the kicker, Zane Gonzalez. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And the kick by Gonzalez is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. If you're thinking of a comeback here, you go to 2016. That's when Stafford had an NFL record 8 fourth quarter comebacks. But last year, despite playing all 16 games, he had 0. Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The second quarter starts off with a bang as they snag over 30 yards.
That could very well be a defining play in this game. A touchdown? That gives them the lead, and they took a major step towards getting there with that big play right there.
So the big play gets them across midfield now for first and 10. Faking the give to Johnson. Now it's Stafford. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Back-to-back plays of right around 30 yards, and the field position has totally been flipped.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. They'll hand it off now, Johnson. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
They go to Johnson again. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
So the penalty erases their earlier loss. Now it's 2nd and 8. Operating from the gun, Stafford. Throw left side, taken in by Galladay. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is 3rd and inches. They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold them.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. From the gun, Stafford. And this is going to be incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. First down, and he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now Murray. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. To throw, it's Murray. Fitzgerald's got it right side. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. Murray going to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can live with incompletions in this situation. You can't live with these short gains that take time off the clock.
You know who loves it? This defense. Murray, he's used to moving fast at Oklahoma. He'll get his guys up to the line. To throw is Murray. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Christian Kirk, the man he was looking for, and it'll bring up third down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Murray now to throw. He gets it left side to Johnson. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts, as he'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. Here's Andy Lee now. He's been terrific so far. Oh, they come after him, and it's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. 20! And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about. So a special teams mistake on a long punt return.
And think about the momentum that leaks out after that play, right? It's built up, terrific return, everyone's excited, but that flag on the ground can bring it way, way back.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Now Stafford. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
So the face mask puts them in even better shape than they were in, as they'll have a short field here on first and 10. The left side completion to Jones. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. To the 20. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it here with a minute 7 remaining. The Lions on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Now a handoff, Johnson. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. The Cardinals forced to burn their 3rd and final timeout as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. So here comes the veteran Matt Prater in a big spot in this ballgame. This for the lead in the final stages. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
Now it's Martin to do the honors after the made field goal. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. All eyes on the Cardinals now. Down by a field goal, 55 seconds remaining. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up 1st and 10. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
You gotta get the ball, D, get the ball right here, let's go.
Now Murray. He's gonna flip that out to the flat, it's complete. Not able to go anywhere that time, 2nd down.
That's what I'm talking about, nice hit, boy.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10.
They'll look to throw.
This complete to the tight end Clay. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
No timeout. You got to go quick here.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. He's back to throw. It's complete. It's Fitzgerald. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Down to 3 seconds. 2 seconds. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.